What operations can we perform on a qubit? Remember that a qubit is a vector, here expressed in terms of the standard basis. If I perform an operation on a qubit, I want to end up with another qubit. So instead of this one, maybe after the operation, I want to end up with this new qubit down here. We start with a vector and end with a vector, so it's natural that the transformation that we're going to apply is some matrix U applied to our starting qubit psi that gives us a new vector. The question is now, can we just put any matrix there? Or does this U have to satisfy certain property? Remember that the qubit is of course a vector, but we wanted this vector to be normalized. So we need to make sure that it remains a qubit. We've also seen that this is quite important because it tells us that the sum of the probabilities, if we're going to measure this qubit, is going to be 1. So we certainly want that also for our new qubit, the inner product is 1. So also for my new qubit, the inner product is 1. So let me compute what this means in terms of the matrix U. So remember first that the definition of the bra is the conjugate transpose. So I take the conjugate transpose of psi and the conjugate transpose of U, which we'll call U dagger. So if I write this out, I get this is equal to psi, u dagger, u psi. So we want our operation u to be independent of the vector. We would like to perform this operation on potentially any qubit that we start with. This means that this term here has to be 1 for all psi that I start with. And this is only possible if U dagger U is equal to the identity matrix. So the identity matrix means that I do nothing. Identity matrix applied to psi gives me back the vector psi. The identity matrix is just this, for one qubit. Note that if we write it like this, we thus see that this is a condition that we want our matrix U to satisfy. We also see that we could have thought SU dagger as an inverse operation. If I apply u to my vector psi to get to the new vector, it's the same, and then apply u dagger to go back. It's the same as doing nothing. Applying the identity. So of course we could have done exactly the same calculation, where we actually now also start applying this inverse operation. It's also an operation and would give us another qubit when I start with psi. So this will give us a condition that looks almost the same, only u and u dagger are now interchanged. U, u dagger should also be equal to the identity. Let's summarize what transformations are possible. We see that any operation we can apply is given by a matrix U, satisfying that U dagger U, or also U U dagger, equals the identity matrix. A matrix verifying this condition is called a unitary matrix. If you're a physicist and are familiar with Schrödinger's equation, then you know that for any Hamiltonian, the evolution of the state in time is indeed unitary. Let's now consider a simple example of a unitary operation. Let us now consider a simple example of a unitary operation. The unitary that we will consider is often written as H for the Hadamard transform. And this unitary transformation is given by the following matrix. 1 over square root 2, 1, 1, 1, minus 1. Note that here, in fact, the conjugate transpose of H is just H itself. So we say that such a matrix, where its conjugate transpose is equal to itself, is Hermitian. Let's see what this unitary actually does. Let's, for example, apply this unitary to the zero of the standard basis. Let me write out the unitary and the vector of the standard basis. So if I perform this calculation, I get 1 over square root 2 times 1, 1. And we've seen this state a few times, namely I can also write this as 1 over square root 2, 0 plus 1, which is the state plus. Let's verify that if we apply the Hadamard to the state 1, that you should be getting the state minus. I'm not going to do this calculation, but you should convince yourself that this is the case. Note that if we apply a unitary to an element of the standard basis, it also means that the transformation preserves the inner product. In fact, this was exactly the condition. U dagger U is equal to the identity. So, of course, we know that 0 and 1 are orthogonal in the beginning. So, if we apply the Hadamard transform to them, we also must end up with two vectors which are orthogonal. So if u0 gives us plus, u1 should give us minus, potentially up to some global prefactor in front. This was an example of a unitary transformation.